So hello everyone, I hope you are able to see my screen. And am I audible to you? If anyone can say yes, then just let us proceed.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, right. Yeah, so the one question is related to the quiz 8 for question number 5 and 8. Those who made an attempt for the quiz 8. So some problem is coming for them. That's what the two, three students have informed me. So the question is something like this: create a new instance of the phone object with the name my phone and properties. So these are the properties of that my phone object. So of course, the answer is correct. But can anyone find out what is the mistake here? So if you quickly look into this, answer is correct. What is the required answer and the student given answer, both are correct only. There's no wrong in that, but still the machine says it is wrong. So you can see it on my screen. This is what a sample copy, what I'm trying to show you. Can you figure it out? What is that mistake? Yes, please. Maybe anyone can share your mic. You can unmute and you can present your version, your solution or your idea. So let it be just a discussion among ourselves. Let us have a common discussion. It is not just only from the teacher. Some kind of you call it as a cooperative learning. So even the students can come forward. Of course, I know the answer, but let me just find out if anybody is able to find out that what is the mistake here. So I'm just once again showing you that screen. This is the screen. The student has given my phone is equal to new space phone smart 4G iPhone within the quotes followed by semicolon. But the correct answer given by me onto the machine is this one. Can anyone find out what is the mistake here between these two statements? This is related to the JavaScript, of course, the quiz number 8, question number 5. Yes, please. Please do come forward. Please try for yourself. Try what can be the mistake in this answer. Because tomorrow onwards, anyway, you are going to do some coding related to the web applications. Definitely, you should also know. And of course, the answer for this is already you have been studied in the first unit. The answer is related to what you have studied in the, what you have learned in the first unit. Because from now onwards, you may also try to see this kind of problems. You may get it on your web pages. Of course, the solution is very trivial in the sense it is very simple. Extra space after the comma. That is one extra space after the comma. Yeah, he has closely observed this one. Yes. And one more is there. One more issue is also there here. Please kindly go see it properly. Okay, so let me give the answer here. So of course, apostrophe, yes, Ashwani Rupa, you are right. Right where before my phone, of course, when you write it in the JavaScript program, usually you are going to mention that this my phone is basically a variable. Yeah, you need not specify the data type. That's what a loosely typing information, because JavaScript is a loosely typed language. You need not specify the data type. Of course, where here is not that much concern. But see, what happens is the characters, what I have given in the solution part of that question is not matching to the characters what the student has typed here. So there are one is an extra space, another is on the apostrophes. That's what your quotation marks. So what happened? These are your open quotes are there here. So these open quotes, which are not matching to this. So a quote is also a character, and the characters are not matching to this. Of course, I mentioned the ignore case, but the quotes are going to be very much concerned for the statement. That's why it is giving a incorrect match. Do not worry about this. Next time onwards, we'll try to make sure that these kind of problems will not arise in your solutions. But anyway, nevertheless, when you copy some quotes from some editors or from some web pages onto your systems, also you may also face this kind of problems. So you need to be very careful, because this is what character encodings are. You have studied in first unit the character encoding. The UTF-8 encoding is going to be very strict in terms of your quotes. So that is what you need to understand here. The quotes are not matching, basically, and the space character. These are the two things that are not matching to the answer given by the teacher and the student. That's the reason why they are not getting matched. So, of course, logically the statement is correct, but syntactically, that's why the characters are not matching. It is getting wrong. Other than that, nothing else. There is not a very big problem. Similarly to the other question too. Here, the other question is on this document.getElement. The quotations are not getting matched onto this fill in the blank. So this is the two questions. Of course, you make an attempt. I will try to, because already some students have made an attempt and they already scored. Now I will not change it. But when I evaluate that complete for all the students who have submitted, then I will check the answers what you are given, and I'll accordingly assign the marks to you. So most probably by another next Saturday, you'll get back your assessment result of this quiz 8. Once your deadline is over, then I will evaluate it and update your marks. So that is one doubt. That's what I have seen in the last 2-3 days. And I have not received any other doubts, I think, I suppose, from my mail. So if anyone is having any doubts, you can put forward that in this session. And I would like to just give you some other information here. Yeah, just if anybody is having any doubts, let put forward. Otherwise, I'll just give some information to you. You can as well post your doubts on the chat session. So yeah, I have not received any doubts so far. So the latest things that are happening with respect to your JavaScripts and your web applications is one such is this one, ML5.js, friendly machine learning for the web. I would just like to brief you here. Of course, this is not there in our syllabus, but like to make you to understand that people are now executing your ML frog machine learning algorithms. Machine learning algorithms, your neural networks, K nearest neighbors, K means, feature extractors. Like this, there is one library called as ML5, machine learning 5, .js. You know what is it? .js. .js implies that it's basically your JavaScript 5. So you can, this is like a library, like stdio.h for your C programs. Similarly, ml5.js is a library which will help you to perform your AI methods running on your browser at the client side itself, not at the server side. So ml5 is a machine learning for the web in the web browser. So this is what is mostly useful. I will tell you how to write the programs and how to execute it. But I prepared for today only, but what happened is I could see only 24 students at this moment. So I'll just wait for some more time and show you how to execute these ML machine learning algorithms on the web browser, the artificial intelligence. So of course, these artificial intelligence techniques are applied for various application domains. So you might have seen across the different domains, people are applying AI and ML algorithms on the browser itself. So we have two different, three different libraries, such as ML5.js, then P5.js, then TensorFlow. TensorFlow.js. There are three different libraries are there now for us. So for the last 2 3 years, the Google, I'll show you one website. You can also browse it. Yeah, this Google's website called Teachable Machine. You can train your computer to recognize your own images, sounds, and poses. So here, people use something called ML5, P5, your Node.js. This Node.js also you are going to study in the next unit. So of course, those people who are very much interested in the designing paintings and all, so you can go for Corel. So here, TF. TF stands for TensorFlow. You are able to, of course, you are able to see it from my screen. So this is a Google's project. For the last 3 4 years, people are doing lot of works are going on. You can train your own models, you can export it, you can run your systems on your mobile phones, on your laptops. So a lot of things can be done here. So sorry, there is a problem from my side. There's a problem from my side, internet connectivity. I hope now you are able to view me, right? As well as you can hear me. Hello. Yeah. So I was what I'm telling to you is now there is a one Google's project called as a Teachable Machine. So this Teachable Machine basically uses library files, the JavaScript library files called TensorFlow Machine Learning ML5 P5.js. Then, of course, Node.js also you'll be studying in the next unit. So, this is basically without writing a single line of code, you can build your own artificial intelligence machine learning model for your mobile phone. You can run your for your mobile phone. And as well as you can run out in your, on your browser itself, the machine learning methods can be executed on your browser. So something like this called they call it the project is called as Teachable Machine. Now the interesting thing here is that this Teachable Machine is basically uses the library softwares called ML5, P5, TF5, TF.js, Node.js. These are all your JavaScript files, JavaScript's library files. So this is one particular JavaScript library files, which is very much useful for today's technology to apply various machine learning and AI algorithms on the browser and on the resource constrained devices like your mobile phone or onto the Raspberry Pis or IoT devices or small electronic gadgets where there is less processing capability, less memory, less communication capabilities and all, so that you can apply your machine learning algorithms. But all these are running with your JavaScript library files only. So one among them library file is called ml5.js. This is a friendly machine learning for the web. So you have to, once you understand the JavaScript, what is a JavaScript, how to write a JavaScript, how various applications can be developed using JavaScript, then we can write one small algorithm using this JavaScript. So this, I will give you the example. Of course, this is, please submit, screen is not visible. My God. So yeah, sorry. Now I hope you're able to see my screen. Yes, sir. Yeah. So this is one something called teachable machine. This is what the Google's project is. So what they have made is, without writing a single line of code on your machine, you can run your machine learning algorithms. Your AI algorithms can be run on your web browser. Not only on the web browser, but on your mobile phone, on your Android phone, on your iOS phones, as well as on small electronic devices where there is small a microcontroller or a microprocessor, which contains small capabilities of your processor, storage, and the communication capabilities. So these machine learning algorithms require a lot of computational features, a lot of computational aspects. But what happened is Google has made it very easy. So this Google, what their Google has done is, their Google has provided you some kind of framework, is a software tool which consists of various libraries such as TensorFlow.js, ML5.js, P5.js, Node.js. These are all .js files, library files, where you can apply your machine learning algorithms for various applications. You can see for audio, for video, for images, for so many things. Even without writing a single line of code, you can build up your own applications. So using teachable machine, various robots are also going to be controlled here. So this is what the Google has made for us. Of course, but as a developer, as a web developer, you should know what these libraries consist of, how these application programming interface APIs will be useful for you to design various web applications properly. So this, how to write the program and all, that's what I will give you some examples on Monday's class. But today you can just see these websites. After my session is over, you can just have an idea what is the latest things that are happening and what Google is doing with all this machine learning. So one such library, machine learning library, we call it as ml5.js JavaScript library. This is, so you write a small web page, that means the web script using the JavaScript itself, and your machine learning is going to run on your web browser itself. So of course, this is not there in our prescribed syllabus, but nevertheless, this will give you some kind of insights for you, some kind of idea for you, what is the latest things that are happening. Once you learn about JavaScript, you can as well apply your knowledge and the skills in developing machine learning algorithms for your web browser and for your electronic, small electronic devices. This is the latest things that are happening on the market for you. So if you want to understand these libraries very well and to make use of these APIs methods, application programming interface methods using these libraries, then the fundamentally you should be very much strong in your concepts related to JavaScript. So please make your complete understanding on the JavaScripts, not only JavaScripts, of course, your HTML, CSS. Later we'll see other technologies also which are going to be useful. You can also build this kind of simple things like this. If you go to their website, you can also train your own model now. Those that are having the internet, you can just spend some 10 minutes of your time. You can build your own machine learning algorithms here now using this teachable machine. Please do remember, these are all running on your browser only. On your laptop browser, you can run these things. Something like you can image project. So you can collect the, so from my, I can just show you something like this. Now, what I'm trying to show you is one mobile phone. So I am just collecting all the samples with respect to my mobile phone here. So like this, you collect the different samples, right? So similarly, I am giving the label as mobile phone. This is mobile. Similarly, I can now train up. So I am giving for another class of objects using a pen. So I'm just collecting the samples with respect to the pen. So like this, the more the samples you collect, the more accuracy is going to be there in classifying what is the object. So I have given two objects here. One is a mobile phone, another is a pen. So once like this, you can keep on add your own objects. So like this, once you given some data to your machine, to your browser, now you are going to train the model. So training is taking place here. It all depends on your internet speed. So it means you, the whatever the information that you are given, the images, the mobile phones and the pens and all, that is going collected onto the cloud. So the training has just started. I have given two sample, means two different objects. Each object is having certain samples, the images that the webcam has collected from my system. So now the training is taking place here. So let us see how just a small example it goes on here. So now you see here, the training is completed. Now if I keep, so here this is a pen, that's what it is classified. Now I'm changing the object. So now if you see, this is the mobile. So this is just a preview here. So this is a mobile phone. It is giving the output. The output it is showing that this is a mobile. So if I put again a pen, it's the output it shows it is a pen. If I put something else, a book, then of course it cannot, is wrongly classifying into some other object here with pens, with certain percentage of pen and certain percentage of mobile phone and all. So the accuracy can be improved basically with more number of data samples you give it. Of course, here you have not written a piece of code. Now this you are going to export model. Once you export it, you can export this as a your JavaScript file you can export, or you can export it as a TensorFlow Lite. This TensorFlow Lite, you can put this code onto your Android mobile phones. Android or your iOS mobile phones, you can export that. So this TensorFlow also you can explore, download it and you can run it on your system. This is what the code actually it is being generated for you. Without writing a single line of code, this teachable machine is going to do a lot of work. But remember, this teachable machine, again, it uses basically various JavaScript libraries. Those JavaScript libraries are nothing but your this. Those JavaScript libraries are, you can see the first one, TensorFlow. You can see it on my screen, TensorFlow. The second one is ML, machine learning. The third one is P5, processing, P5. The next one is Node, Node.js. This is Node.js. So all these things you are going to learn in our coursework. Of course, I will give just introduction to these ML5, P5 in the Monday's class. And Node.js will study it in the next week. So please do spend some time in going through JavaScripts for this Saturday and Sunday. Some basics, so that I'll just complete that introduction part for your ML5 and P5. We'll do some small one or two programs, just a small two programs I will try to execute and show it to you. Later you can practice on your own. With your interest you can go. Of course, this is not there in your syllabus. Just for those people who are very curious to know how JavaScript is going to be useful for their ML5 and P5 application developments and all. For those people, it will be useful for them very much. Right. Any other doubts, please? Because I could see that only JavaScript, very few people have come up to that particular stage. Still, most I don't know anything about ML. So don't worry about ML. Machine learning, you have not studied. One more thing, of course, you may or not study machine learning, but the example what I'm going to give you, it contains all the details. What is machine learning? How you do the simple something like a introductory topic, introduction to machine learning. That we will see it on Monday class. But what I request you all is to complete, if possible, complete. Otherwise, at least understand what it is a JavaScript is. So this JavaScript already last week you have posted the material on the our Moodle class, our course page. So please go through that JavaScript. This is what you material which is given here in your course page. So here, introduction to JavaScript. At least you go through this almost within 1 hour, you should be able to complete this part one, part two, part three. Try to understand those things more properly. Then you will be able to understand what I'm going to tell you, how these JavaScripts are going to be useful for building and running your AI and ML algorithms. Later, when you complete your machine learning course, you can apply your JavaScript libraries very well on to develop your new models and new applications. You can easily go through it. Sir, can you show us how to develop a simple website for sample? Very much curious for you. Okay. Let me just, okay, like we could learn how to use these concepts for assignments. Okay, this is what actually, if you can wait for another up to Monday at least, Gayatri. Why? Because I am not just trying to postpone all the things. You may be very much eager to know how to develop a website and all. So, okay, let me just show now only. Let me try. Whatever I say, it will be thinking that in a different way. Okay, just hold on. Let me open my Ubuntu operating system because we have already installed something called LAMP stack. So there are various ways of the building your own websites, but the way I am trying to show you makes like you need to go from the scratch. Rather than just using the already existing websites, just with some customizations, they will try to help you to build up your own websites. But that is not the important thing that you need to understand here. So let us go from the scratch here. So let me just check whether my LAMP is running or not. One second, just hold on. Okay. What I suggest to you is how to build the website. Like we could learn how to use these concepts for assignment. Gayatri, your way of that question I could not understand. It is not that how to build these assignment questions will help you to build up the website rather than how the website concepts will be useful for your assignment. It is the other way around. Okay, what I mean to say is, if you have seen the assignment properly, that assignment concepts will be helpful for you in developing your web applications. It is not that the website web development concepts will be helpful for you to solve the assignment. So maybe you will be very much clear when you understand how we try to develop a simple website. Okay, so to develop a simple website, let me see, your concepts are not clear, but you have something in your mind, so that's why you are having some curiosity. So all of you may have some curiosity in knowing how to develop the websites and all. So let me explain to you the basic things that required to develop your websites. Okay, so let me start your web. In order to develop your website, what are all the things that are required for your website? To develop a website. So to develop a website, what you require? Anyone, at least with your own idea? You may say that you are not studied, so you don't know what are the things. Let me just put your screen here on the chatting window. Let me see. And this I will try to put it here. Yeah. I will try them and clarify, sir. No, don't worry. Just I am giving a clarification for all of you, those are attending now. Just pay attention for 15, 20 minutes. Not more than that. That is enough for us. Right. So here, all of you, please pay, those who are on the online session, just make yourself attentive to listen to this particular thing. So to develop a website, what are all the things that you require? See, the most important HTML is just for front end. Okay, now see here carefully. See, what does the website contains? Basically, your website contains collection of web pages. Or you can say web sources. So collection of web pages, or we will say web source, or simply some source files. So what does a web page contain? Collection means so many web pages will be there. All those so many web sources or so web pages are put together at one place. That's what your website is. So now what does a web page contain? So basically your web page is a something like is nothing but user interface. A web page is a user interface, means the user is going to interact with the web page. So this user interface is nothing but we call it as your front end. It means the something which is looking in front of the user. That's why this user interface is is nothing but a web page which the user sees or user interacts. So more specifically, this user interface is going to be a graphical one. Then some graphics will be there. Then something like your images, your audio files, your video files, user is going to interact. So many other things is going to consist of. So this is what your web page contains, which is in front of the user. Now, what is, if it is that is in the front end, what is there in the back end? So there is a back end also is going to be another important thing. So at the back end, it's not only database. You have database plus you have web server,
You should also have a programming language. So three important things are there here. What are the three important things? At the back end, you have a database. So you have a database. For what purpose database is used for? Usually for storage only. Yeah. You have something else also is there, a web server. What for the web server is used for? This web server is meant for to provide a common place for your web pages. When I say common place means your web server, it is a server. That's why you call it as a web server. Server means a person is going to serve your request. So whenever some user request comes from your web pages, those web pages requests are going to be served by this web server. And that request which are going to serve comes from a particular common place. That's what your web pages are all put together at that particular web server. So that's what a web server is. And a programming language also is required. Means a programming language to interact to, this is meant for to interact with database and web server and user. User means again that is what your front end. So one programming language which is going to be very much useful to interact with your database, with your web server and the user. So these three things are required here for the back end. One is your database, another is your web server, another is your programming language. Three things are required here. So the three things in order to, all this will constitute your website, or basically you call it as a web application. So in order to develop web applications or web sites or web resources, you require something on the front end and you require something on the back end. So the common software tools that are required in the back end, what are the common software tools required in the back end? Something like a database, you say that to store your data, storage of data. So what is that data? How can be stored? There are so many tools out there. One such tool is your MySQL. MySQL means SQL. SQL stands for Structured Query Language. So you have an Oracle. So Oracle database is there. MySQL database is there. The common databases. These are basically your relational databases which are going to store your data. And also require some. These again, what is this MySQL? Is basically your software only. This is a software. All are softwares. Of course, the front end is a software. All the back ends are also softwares here. So among the web servers, you have something called as open source APSH Apache. Apache web server is also required for you. And you require a programming language, a language which is need to communicate between your database, your web server and the user. So like this, you have a programming language, a scripting language. You have something called as PHP. You have, it can be Perl, it can be Python. Like this, this is a common open source software tools. So now all these things, see this database, web server and programming language, all these things has to be run on a particular operating system. So they, in order to have your database, in order to have your web server, in order to run your programming language statements, all these things has to be run on a OS, that is your operating system. So you can go with Linux, you can go with Windows, you can go with Mac, so on and so forth. You can go depending on your operating system, you can use different things. So that's why if you want to develop your web applications or your websites, you must be aware of what are all these things, how to use these things. Without knowing this one, you cannot. Yes, without knowing these things, you cannot develop your application. So, of course, without knowing all these things also, you can do it. There are software tools are there now available on the web itself. Simply you ask them what you want on the front end, what you want to have it on the user interactivity features, then they will simply click and drag. Those things are there, but we don't want you go into that simple way of to complete the things. You need to know the intricacies, the internal details, how these web services, web applications do communicate with each other, how they can be developed, how they can be used, how they can be used. You need to practice on these things. So what I suggest is, if you want to develop your user interface for a graphical user interfaces, then you should know what is your HTML, you should know what is your CSS, you should know what is your JS, you should know about DOM. At least minimum things, these are the minimum things. So we started to learn all these things in the last week. So once you at least have some understanding about what is HTML, how to use HTML, similarly, what is CSS, how do we use CSS to design and develop your to design and develop your web pages. So your web pages are there here. That's what your web page is. Basically, it is user interface. So you have to use this scripting tools, JavaScript, CSS script, HTML scripts, your DOM concepts to design and develop. So you have to properly design them. Then your request comes here. So the user interacts with these web pages. Those requests have been sent to your backend. So this backend is nothing but basically your server. So this server contains so many other servers. Database server, the web server, the scripting language, the programming language server, or your Windows server, or your Linux server, or your Mac server. So these are the different servers. All these servers are going to be present in the backend. They do some kind of work. So once the user interacts, those requests comes to these people. So here, it is something like this simple diagram here. The simple diagram is, if you can understand this, so here, let me put it in a diagrammatic manner. So you are sitting in front of your laptop, and on a laptop you have a browser. So once you develop your web page, so that web page is going to be available on the browser sitting in front of your laptop. So whenever the user interacts with the web page, you are sitting here. So the request goes from your user. The request goes from your user to your another computer that is nothing but your server here. So this is like a client server model here, basically. So this is the server on the right side. So that server contains, what are all the things? The server contains, these are all the things. The backend, this is the backend. These all, the database server is going to be available here. The web server is going to be available here. The programming language software tool is going to be available on this server. So those servers are going to be useful for providing the requests that are coming from the user, who is sitting here. Something like this. If you are now, what I am doing here, when you are opening your, something like your Moodle website. So what happens in the Moodle website, suppose, so many things that you can read. This is a web page of your Moodle server. The first thing what you do is usually you will log in. So when you enter your username and password, the user is interacting here on this web page. He is entering the username, he is entering the password, and he is clicking this button, login button. Once this click-in happened, the request has went from the browser sitting in front of you. That request went to the server. And once the username and the password are correct here, the database checks that one. Then the server responds with the corresponding site home. This is what you call it as site home. It means another web page has been shown to the user here. So from here, you can go to whatever he wants to do it on this web page. So this is how you are going to how to design these web pages. So to design these web pages, so what is present on the left side? How do you organize your web page with so many things? Something like you can remove this option like this, you can enable this one, you can navigate from one page to this is another page, this is participants page, or this is like your grades page. So different pages are there. You are moving, you are navigating from one page to another page. So like this, you can move from one course to another course. This is your, so this is another page. So how to move from one page to another page? So these are the statements that you need to understand here. That's what we are going to study in our PHP. So the PHP videos are going to be kept mostly by tomorrow, at least for another 3 videos. So once those videos are kept, you are ready with your website developments. So once the videos have been put by tomorrow, you can see those websites and you be ready by at least by Monday or to the next week. So your website design and development will be ready. But mostly by next weekend, you will get the complete idea about how you can design and develop your websites. But prior to that one, what I suggest you all is you have to go to this installation of LAMP, or if you are working on Windows, so those who are working on Linux, you need to install something like LAMP stack, we call it as. In IT terminology, we call it as LAMP stack. LAMP stands for, of course, that's why I told you this is Linux. L stands for Linux, A stands for Apache, M stands for MySQL, P stands for PHP. Those who are working on Windows, you have something called WAMP stack. W stands for Windows. You can download that WAMP from this particular website, which I'm giving you the URL. Those who want to work it on Windows, please. So WAMP server for Windows. You can just go to this WAMP server. This is what you can download your, but this requires Microsoft Visual Studio, some other. Yes, so this is depending on your the laptop, either your 32 bits or your 64 bits, you please download it. Just simply, this is next, next, next. Just next, next buttons has to be clicked. Automatically, your WAMP server will be installed, which contains Apache, PHP, MySQL. Those for you want to develop your websites on your own. And if you want to work it on Windows, you need this WAMP server. So once you install here, there will be a small icon like this, this W. That the icon will be shown at the bottom of your screen. You can see here, which will be once it is installed correctly and it is running, it will show green color here. So those who want to work it on Windows, you can install this WAMP server. But those who want to work on Linux, which I also prefer it, like you can also install your Linux Apache and make your LAMP stack, which is running on my system like this. So you can install this, how to install LAMP stack on the Linux. There is a video of mine itself. You can, I will put the links today on the, so there are some videos are there, how to install LAMP. It will take not more than 10 to 15 minutes of time. So those links, they are available on my YouTube channel itself, but I will put the links on the Moodle website today. And make yourself, your laptops are ready with your LAMP or your WAMP, right? At least by tomorrow or after tomorrow. So once you are ready with those things, you can start designing and developing your web pages and your websites. Now coming to these assignments, the assignment 3, if you have developed your web, means that will give you the ideas how to design your own web pages using HTML, CSS, JavaScript, of course, very much useful, very much required for doing your processing at the client side and as well as at the server side. But mostly at the client side, it will be useful for your JavaScripts. So First, you practice that things. You thought come, some of you may have still not yet completed those things. So I don't want to rush you to go to immediately without completing this basics properly and rush to your installations of those softwares. Anyway, because you asked it and that now the time has come. So you need to now let us, I will put the PHP slides by tomorrow. So next week onwards, you start designing and developing your web pages. So at least you be prepared with your stuff to develop your own websites rather than just depending on XAMPP also you can use it. That is not a problem for you. That XAMPP you can use the cross, which you can run it on your Windows as well as which you can run it on your Linux systems. That is your cross anything. It is anything which is accessible to you. You are most welcome. I can clarify your doubts when you're running on XAMPP or your. Yes, I installed XAMPP. Okay, XAMPP, no problem. Same thing. XAMPP also is done the same thing. It is X instigate. That is a cross. That is, you can run it on that same files can be used to portable onto your Linux and your Windows. XAMPP is also acceptable. PHP admin is acceptable for that. No problem. So you can go for LAMP. You can go for WAMP. You can go for MAMP. You can go for XAMPP. You can go for XAMPP. There are so many tools are there. There are so many stacks are there. Whichever is accessible for you, because I am just giving 2-3 here, because mostly you'll be working on Linux or Windows. That's why I'm giving. Some of you might are not working on Mac systems. That's why I'm not given MAMP. Yeah, any other doubts, please? So next week onwards, we'll start our website's development only. But on Monday, I will give you a brief introduction for your JavaScript's advancements of JavaScript, as well as this PHP. So at least one or two web pages, you should be ready with your HTML and CSS. At least for your email application, what you have made ready, that keep it ready. The assignment question number 8 or 9, I think, the email application or some registration forms. So if you have seen in the these things, those people who have done these assignments, they'll have an idea. So keep ready your samples of this assignment. Three exercises. These three exercises will be useful for you to extend your work. Up to now, nobody has submitted it. Okay. So this assignment 3, the question number is all these questions, customer information, online registration for international seminar, this email message interface, all these 4 questions will be useful for you to continue with your websites again. 1, 2, 3. Of course, the calendar also you can get it, but let us keep it aside. This also. So these 4 questions will be useful for you to continue with your websites. That we will do it from next week onwards. There are directly developing a website, but that is not the correct way of learning. You should understand what is PHP does, what does MySQL does, and what does these LAMP stacks does. So that is the steps that we need to go one by one. Yeah. Any other doubts, please?